So as part of the last module, we discussed the role of instruction set architecture, the ISA classification, and memory addressing. So in this module, we are going to discuss the addressing modes. So why do we need addressing modes? So a typical instruction consists of an opcode and a couple of operands. And opcode will specify the type of operation the instruction is going to perform. And the operands are going to specify the data item value or the address of the data item that they are referring. Typically, an instruction consists of few bits. And so as a result, operand cannot, because the number of bits allocated in the operand field is very limited. So as a result, it's not possible to reference large address space. And sometimes the operands will directly provide the constant values. And some other cases, the operands can refer an address of a register or a memory location. So effectively, the ISAs make use of this addressing modes to specify the way in which operands of an instruction are stored. So in this module, we are going to discuss 6 addressing modes. Of course, there are several addressing modes are there in several ISAs and so on. So we start with an immediate addressing. So I'm going to explain these addressing modes with a pictorial representation. Consider an instruction which consists of 2 parts. One is the opcode field, and the other one is an operand field. And in the case of immediate addressing, your operand field actually contains the actual value the instruction is referring to. So a typical example of an immediate addressing is add R1 comma operand, where the operand is a constant value the address, the add instruction is using. So this addressing mode is typically used for accessing constants. And the main advantage with this addressing mode is there's no need of a memory reference, because the value required by the instruction is directly available in the address field or operand field. The disadvantage with this is the limited address space. The reason is, as we know, a typical instruction can consist of few bits, and in that some bits will be already allocated for the opcode. So as a result, the number of bits allocated per operand field is very limited. So using that, we can reference only a limited address space. The second addressing mode we considered is the direct addressing. So the difference between the direct addressing mode and the immediate addressing mode is, in the immediate addressing mode, operand field contains the value, but whereas in the case of direct addressing mode, the operand field contains the address of a memory location where the actual operand value is stored. So effectively, once we decode the instruction, we get this address from the operand field, and we use that address and access the memory to get the actual operand value. A typical example of this direct addressing mode is add R1 comma A, where A specifies the address of a memory location. So typically, this addressing mode is used for accessing static data, because typically static data is stored in the memory rather than the registers. So it requires only one memory reference compared to the other addressing modes that we discuss in a short while. The disadvantage with this addressing mode is still the limited address space. The number of addresses we refer using the operand field is limited, because our operand field width is very limited here. So similar to the immediate addressing mode, it has a disadvantage of having limited address space. So in order to increase the address space, we can use the next addressing mode, which is called as memory indirect. So here our operand field specifies the address of a location Once we go to that location, we actually get the address of the actual operand. So it's like an indirection. From the operand field value, we go to a memory location. This memory location in turn contains the address of the actual operand. We go to that location and get the actual value. So here, the typical example of this addressing mode is add R1 comma A within parenthesis. This A within parenthesis indicates the indirection. So typically this addressing mode is used for pointer manipulations, and the main advantage compared to the previous two addressing modes is the large address space. But the main disadvantage with this memory indirect addressing mode is it requires two memory accesses. First memory access is to get the actual address of the operand, and the second memory access is to get the actual operand. So similar to this memory addressing modes, because as I said previously, operands can be specified as address in a memory location or address in a register file. So we come up with two other addressing modes which use the address in a register file rather than in a memory. So the first one is register addressing. This is analogous to direct addressing mode. Rather than accessing the memory, we access an address location in the register file specified by the operand field. A typical example of this addressing mode is add R1 comma R, where R specifies the address of a register in the register file. It is typically used for accessing values stored in registers. And we know that register access is much faster compared to memory access and so on. So a register addressing mode can be used for performance of the system. And the main advantage with this register addressing mode is it will not require any memory reference because our values are stored in the registers and we always access the register file to get these values. But the disadvantage is, again, because the operand field width is limited, so as a result, we cannot access a large memory address space. The next addressing mode is register indirect, where the operand field specifies the address of a register in the register file, and we go to that register file, access that particular address location, and that in turn contains the address of a memory location in memory. So go to the memory and access that location and get the actual operand value. Typical example here is add R1 comma R within parenthesis. Again, as I mentioned earlier, R within parenthesis indicates the indirection. And this type of addressing mode is typically used for pointer manipulations, similar to memory indirect addressing mode. And because we finally access the memory to get the actual operand value, so we can provide large address space. But compared to register addressing mode, the register indirect addressing mode has a drawback, which is it incurs one memory access. Remember, memory accesses are time consuming compared to register accesses. And finally, we consider very important addressing mode, which is called as displacement addressing mode. In this displacement addressing mode, we have an operand field which specifies the offset or the displacement, and we may have another operand field which specifies the register address, but the second operand is optional here. So we may specify the register explicitly in the instruction, or this register can be represented implicitly. A typical example of this addressing mode is add R1 comma A within brackets R. So here A specifies the displacement from the address specified by the contents of register R. And this addressing mode actually combines the benefits of both direct addressing mode and the register indirect addressing mode. And it provides more flexibility in using this addressing mode in various scenarios. But the drawback with this addressing mode is it's complex to implement compared to the other addressing modes. So now we are going to look at the uses of displacement addressing mode. As I mentioned, the displacement addressing mode actually specifies the displacement or an offset from a particular address. This address can be specified explicitly by a register operand or by an implicit register location. So we can use this in relative addressing. So what is relative addressing? So relative addressing specifies that the displacement is relative to the address of the current instruction. We know that the program counter typically stores the address of the next instruction to be executed. So whenever we have a jump instruction or control transfer instructions, we know the next instruction address, and all we have to give is we specify the displacement with respect to the next instruction address in the operand field of the displacement addressing mode, so that we can directly go to the specified target address. So as a result, this relative addressing mode is also called as PC relative, and this is mainly used in control transfer instructions. This displacement addressing mode can also be used in base register addressing. So here again, we can specify the base address in a specific register, and the displacement can be specified in the operand field, so that we displace, or the next instruction can be executed at an address which is a displacement distance from the contents in the base register. So the reference register contains a memory location. Typically we use the segment registers, so which contains the address of a segment, and the displacement can be provided in the operand field, so that this base register addressing is typically used to implement segmentation in the systems. And finally, this displacement addressing mode can also be used for indexed addressing. This indexed addressing actually performs in reverse to the base register addressing. So here our address field contains a memory address, and the reference register, as I mentioned earlier, it can be explicitly mentioned or an implicitly mentioned, which contains a displacement from the memory address. So typically this type of addressing mode is used in performing operations on arrays or iterative computations. So in summary, there are several addressing modes proposed in several ISAs, and these addressing modes will provide design trade-offs. Some addressing modes will reduce the instruction count. That will be good for reducing our overall CPU time, as we discussed in one of the previous modules. But when these addressing modes reducing the instruction count, they may incur the high CPI, clocks per instruction. So as a result, we need to be careful in selecting our addressing modes, such that it should not complicate the overall design, it should not increase the CPI, average CPI of the system, and also it should not increase the overall computation time. And 80x86 ISA supports the register addressing mode, immediate addressing mode, and displacement addressing mode with variations, which include zero registers, one register, and two registers. When I say displacement addressing mode with zero registers, so there is no the reference register, or a displacement is absolute value. And in the case of displacement with one register, we can implement our relative addressing mode, as we discussed earlier, or we can implement the base register addressing mode. So, and when we consider displacement addressing with the two registers, typically this is used for implementing multi-dimensional arrays and so on, where we can use base index displacement addressing mode or base scaled index displacement addressing modes. And in the case of ARM ISA, we have support for register addressing mode, immediate addressing mode, displacement with one and two registers. It also supports a PC relative addressing mode, and in addition to that, it supports auto increment and auto decrement. So these auto decrement and auto increment addressing modes we have not discussed earlier, but actually this auto increment and decrement, typically it does a specific thing. When we access a memory location, automatically the address of the location either incremented or decremented respectively. So typically when we want to design a new ISA, we need to ensure that at least these three addressing modes are supported. Those are displacement, immediate, and register indirect addressing modes. And also, because when we are dealing with displacement addressing modes, so displacement field or the operand field size, we have to be careful about that. If we give too much displacement field width, so we may not support many operations because the number of bits in an instruction is limited. And similarly, when we are implementing the immediate addressing mode, we have to ensure that the bit field for this immediate value also should be considered reasonable value. So otherwise, again, so it has an impact on the overall instruction length. So in summary, so choose the best addressing modes required for your ISA depending on the target applications you are looking for the computer. And when we are considering the displacement addressing mode and immediate addressing modes, choose reasonable size operand bit fields for these two addressing modes. Thank you.